Please like and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to get new video updates.
Chapter 4. Meeting Michael, the week flew by quicker than I could imagine. I hate weekends. Nothing to do and no friends to visit. Lillian has flown to Paris with Danny to shop for her wedding gown. I was supposed to go with her, but I've been busy with work, and since I just resumed, I didn't want to ask for any excuse just yet. Sitting in front of my TV, my favorite program was on, The Thundermans. I know you all wondering why a grown-up like me is watching kid movies. I so love it, and right now with nothing to do, I have no choice but to watch what I have. I was watching Thundermans with popcorn beside me when I heard the doorbell. I left to open the door only to see Debbie standing in front of my doorstep. Unlike me, she was dressed while I was just in boom short and crop top. Hey, she smiled widely at me, checking me out with disgust. Looking back at her, she was all smile, which made me wonder if I was hallucinating. Reaching forward to touch me, 1 meter, so sorry to bother you, but I and my fiancé is hanging out and I was wondering if you'd like to join us. Are you sure? I was skeptical. I know she won't mind, cause she is loving and kind, but I doubt her fiancé will like it. Yes, and don't worry about Michael, the first told him. I told him about you, and he's excited to meet you. Michael. That name again. I've been hearing Michael everywhere I go in any time. I glance back, there will be no one there. It as if 1 meter hearing things, and it's driving me crazy. Okay. I will just change out of this. I gesture to my clothing. And she smiles. I invited her in, but she declined, saying she prefers to stay in the car with Michael. I only just noticed the red Benz parked in front of my house. Wow. Her fiancé must be really rich. I couldn't see him cause it was tainted. After ransacking through my wardrobe on what to wear, I settle on a black fitted straight gown which was just below the knee. And it shows off my hourglass figure since I was of average height. I pair it with nude flat slippers and a nude color purse with my phone intact. And my house keys. I locked up and went to the car. Debbie opened the back door for me since she was sitting in the front seat, and I make myself comfortable in the back and I suck in breathe when I notice the person in the driver's seat. I can never forget his black hair. Nina, meet Michael. Michael, that Nina. I stretch my hand to greet him politely. Immediately Debbie made the introduction, but he responded with a nod without looking back. The drive to the restaurant was the worst outing of my life, cause I couldn't contain my fury when Debbie keep holding Michael's arms and resting her head on his shoulder. They were conversing like couples that love each other so much. I was jealous and so stupid. I wish I was the one who was talking to him, that I was one resting my head on his shoulder. I wish a lot of things, but he didn't even look at me twice. He was just conversing with Debbie about the weather, about their wedding. I didn't want to listen to them anymore, so I plug in my earphone and listen to music on my phone. But I couldn't stop the erratic beating of my heart. Immediately we got to the restaurant Royal. Debbie taps me on my shoulder and we went in. Welcome to Royal Restaurant. The waitress greeted us and guided us to a table at a secluded place. Immediately when we arrived at the restaurant. What will you like to order? Lisa, as her name tag read. Open a notepad with a pen to take down our order. We all order pasta and begin to eat. Michael tried to speak to me in Italian, knowing very well that Deborah wouldn't understand cause she's American. But I was just giving him the cold shoulder like I didn't understand anything he says. The meal was delicious. Everyone busy with their food when I decided to break the silence. So when is the wedding? I drop my fork and wipe my mouth with the napkin as I look from Michael to Deborah. We've not picked the date yet, but we've done the engagement and introduction. We are still thinking about the day and month to use, and any time we do that I will let you know, and I would love you to be my bridesmaid. Deborah also drops her fork and turns to me to reply. Really? Are you giving me that spot? Of course. Yes. You're my friend. Moreover, I don't have any friends to begin with. You're the only one I know, so yes, I would love for you to have that spot. Really. Thanks so much, I said excitedly, the smile not reaching my heart. Who best someone who is getting married to the man you love? I look at Michael, but he seems oblivion to whatever we were saying as he typed away on his phone. Thanks for yesterday. It was fun. I smile genuinely at her as I remember the fun we had. Debbie's face hardened as she looks at me. She suddenly turned to Michael and smiled. Can you believe that Nina here has only had sex once? I was embarrassed. I never believed she could do that, but no one is to be trusted except Lillian. Michael turns to look at me, as fights to hide the smile on his lips. She said she had a one-night thing with a guy some years back. She continues. Is that what you call it now? I thought you call it love then. He turned to Debbie and smiled. Why didn't you date another man? Miss Miller? He said as he regards me, challenging me not to answer. Oh, so we are back to Miss Miller. I knew what he's trying to do and one meter ever ready for him. Well, there was no time. I was busy with schoolwork then and now one meter very busy with work. Mr. Thompson, I smiled at him. How long have you had a nightstand with that guy? He asked, trying to hide his smile. I know the games he's playing, but who can play this game? For 10 years. Mr. Thompson, I said sweetly as I turned to Debbie, who was staring at us like we've grown 2 heads each. 10 years is such a long time to hold a grudge. Miss Miller, don't you think so? He said while looking at Debbie for support. She nodded while looking at us closely. I was getting scared. What if she knows? I can't risk her relationship with Michael because of me. I try to ignore Michael, but he's no one to back down until he has all his answers. I never say one meter holding a grudge. He is not the kind of person I can love, I replied while looking at him. His grips tightened on the cup. Wow, have just mashed his ego. I smiled to myself. Why did you say so? Debbie asked curiously. Because he couldn't wait for the next morning to say goodbye. He left after taking my virginity. He disappears me like trash, I scream angrily. Debbie froze. I smile sadly at her while she looks on. I'm sorry, that was a sensitive topic. How did you and Michael meet? I said, trying to move the attention from me. She smiles happily. We met at a birthday party 10 years ago. 10 years ago. I question softly as I did the math in my head. Michael and Debbie were together before he came unto me. Gosh, I hate him so much. Yes. It was after we met that we found out that our parents were friends, and then one thing led to another and now we are engaged. Really. That's good. But why did you wait so long? You could have married earlier, like 3 or 4 years ago. Yes. We could have. But we were only friends then. We just found out recently that we were both in love with each other, and then we decided to get married. She said as she stood up to hug and kiss Michael. 10 years is such a long time to get to know someone. Don't you think? Mr. Thompson? I slap his words back at him. His face hardened as I cleared his throat and stood up. One meter afraid, ladies. But I have to cut short your chit-chat. I have 1 or 2 things to do at the office. He signals the waitress and paid for our lunch. As we all turned to leave, immediately we got to the parking lot. The valet brought the car over while Michael offers to take me home. No, don't worry about me. I don't want you to be late for wherever is it that you're going to, I refuse blatantly. I didn't say I was worried, he said as he walked to the driver's side after opening the door for Debbie to get in. But he can still drop you off, right, Michael? Debbie said. She seems happy that I refuse the ride, though I wonder why. Maybe it's just my imagination. Thankfully, Michael didn't force me, though I wanted him to. He reached over to fasten Debbie's seatbelt as he perks her softly on the lip. I didn't wait for them to leave. As I walked down the road to the park, which was not far from the restaurant, I never would have believed that I will see him so soon and in the arms of another woman. Happy. I walked down the street with tears in my eyes as passers-by keep glancing at me. I was like a fool in love. I sat down at the park as I watched couples laughing and smiling to themselves, oblivion to the people around them. I felt jealous of them. I never really had a proper relationship that involves dates and romantic dinner. Even after seeing what Michael did, my heart still beats for him. I get butterflies anytime I hear his face. All those times at school, I rejected different offers just because I wanted to keep myself for him, thinking that he will come back for me. My phone ringing brought me out of my thought. Mom, I call immediately. I answer the phone. Ina, have you been crying? She said, her voice laced with concern. Have missed her voice? She and Lillian are the only one that calls me Ina. No. Mom, I reply quickly. I'm down with cold. That's why my voice is sounding that way. Okay. Gia, have taken drugs? Mom asks. I could hear the clicking of pants in the background. She's in her shop. Yes. Mom, 1 meter fine. How's Shane? He is fine. Mom said as he calls to him. I can hear his voice in the background. Oh, I've missed my little brother so much. Hiya, big sis. He calls happily into the phone. I laugh happily. Hiya, back little bro. How are you? I'm good sis. And you? 1 meter good too. Are you sure? It looks like you've been crying. Leave it to my little brother to worry about me. Sure. Why did you think otherwise? Is it Michael? He asked. I was shocked. How did he know? I never told anyone about him. Shane? How did you know? I guess so too. I've seen you cry yourself to bed every night after reading that letter. I might be 7 but 1 meter not stupid. He said, sounding angry. I couldn't stop the tears that fell from my eyes. I cried loudly into the phone as my brother tried to comfort, getting angrier the more. Did you see him? He asked me after I had quieted down. Yes. But he's engaged to someone. What? Shane shouted, causing Mom to ask him what's wrong. Nothing, Mom. He replies. That son of a bitch. He swore loudly. Did you tell anyone? I ask him as I ignore that he swore. No. He should better treat your right or else. He said and hung up. I smile. He's always acting like an adult. I shrug that between Michael and him. I don't care. I walk back home. My heart light now that I've spoken to Shane about it. I miss Lily so much. She's the only person that would know what to do in such a situation. Why don't you fight for him after all? You're still in love with him. My subconscious said, getting tired of this cat and dog games we are playing. That's easier said than done. And what should I do about Debbie? Who cares about Debbie? She counters back. Probably not understanding me anymore. Even I don't understand myself. All is fair in love and war. Baby girl, she continues. I wish I was brave like her. I wish she was me and I her. She has a feisty personality that I admire about her. Okay, accepted that all is fair in love and war. But Michael doesn't love me. I can see it in his eyes and the way he treated Debbie today. She retreated to the back of my mind, not knowing what to say anymore. While I walk home with a heavy heart. When I got home, I check on Debbie at her apartment, but she was not yet back. Did they go to his house? Or maybe they went to his parents? Or maybe they are having sex right now in his room with lighted candles, since you said he loves her? My subconscious said. She's back now to taunt me. I ignore her as I walk with a heavy heart to my apartment. I didn't even bother to cook or eat. I went straight to bed as I kick and turn, trying badly to sleep, but it just wouldn't come. I took out the letter Michael left for me and read it over and over again as the tears keep flowing. I finally went to bed with the letter in my hand and tears in my eyes.